Welcome to the Scoop School Podcast, where we tackle your conundrums about the retail ice cream and frozen dessert business. And now, here's your host.
He's so ice cream, he called his kids Ben and Jerry. And they're girls.
The ice cream bloke and self-appointed headmaster of Scoop School, Steve Christensen.
G'day ice cream lovers, Steve Christensen's my name. Hey, thanks for joining us on the podcast. We are getting desperately close to 1,000 subscribers. I know that's not as much as Cutie Pie or PewDiePie, whoever those crazy YouTubers are, but 1,000 people logging into these videos and basically getting ice cream focused, frozen dessert focused content every day, I think's pretty good. So let's push us over the edge. I think at the time that this airs, we're gonna have close to 900. Let's get the last 100 pushed through the door and then onward and upward from 1,000. In any case, subscribe. I know you're going to enjoy the content that we provide every day. I do want to thank our episode sponsor here, which is iriceco.com, based out of Philadelphia, shipping all over the country. Whether you're talking Italian ice or water ice, one of their foundational products, but now they offer so much more in the realm of toppings, fudges, flavors, bases, extracts, and all the things that you need to go either on or in your ice cream to flavor it. iriceco.com. We'll have a link to their website in the show notes below here. Now, I do want to touch on a subject which a lot of people talk about, which is, should I close my store in the wintertime? This will air probably close to the end of November, if not the early December months of 2017 in the United States. And for the most part, a lot of people who actually only have seasonal ice cream or seasonal frozen dessert businesses have more than likely closed their doors. But there are a lot of people right on the cusp of deciding, do I close, do I not? What are the benefits? What are the pros and cons? And I do want to touch on just two here. One of them is probably one of the ones that you may not think about. So first of all, obviously there's a financial calculation to know whether you should stay open or not. You should have a relatively good idea of what your fixed costs are. Now, fixed costs in the ice cream world are the expenses that you need to pay every single month, regardless of whether you open the doors or not. And they generally come into the category of rent. If you are renting your business or whether you have a mortgage, it's going to be that rent or mortgage payment. It's more than likely going to be some utilities, whether it be power and water to come to the store. Obviously, they fluctuate a little bit, but you'll have an idea of what it'll cost you to keep utilities going to your store if you're not open. Insurance is another one. And there might be some lease payments on equipment that you will have. So what you've got to do is figure out what your standard or fixed costs are, even if you don't open the door. Now, you take that fixed cost and you look at, okay, if I was to open, how many employees or staff members will I need to keep this product going? And in the winter months or the slower months, you shouldn't need, obviously, you might need a third of the employees that you would need during your summer months or your busy times. And you'll do that calculation as to what that break even will be. We actually have a video on breaking even, which I'll put a link down here in the show notes as well. But here's the thing. You've got to figure that there's a line there. Now, whether it be you're losing a little bit or you're breaking even to keep open during the winter time, that's a decision that you'll need to make. One thing I do want to talk about is customer loyalty and whether your customers are going to another ice cream shop or another food-based business that sells ice cream or frozen desserts and basically are building loyalty to someone else while you're closed for the winter. Now, every single customer in our stores that we had in Australia, the stores that we had here in the US, every single customer promises, we'll come during the winter, please stay open. It's not always that simple, and people obviously can't commit by contract to keep coming back. But every now and again, even though you may be closed, you might have someone, one of your customers, that think, boy, I really want some ice cream. I'll go to this place down the road that sells food and ice cream. I'll give you a classic example. So a little west of St. Louis is a smaller town called Wentzville. And there was a frozen custard store in Wentzville that used to close for the winter time. So their customers, very loyal customers, would come during the summer months and then hit that fall or autumn period where it started to get colder and the sales would drop off. And so this store, particular frozen custard store, would close. Now, during one of those winters, a place that sold burgers, fries, and frozen custard opened up in the town. And all of the people who had that kind of hankering for frozen custard in the winter months, when store A was closed, they went to this new startup, this new restaurant that sold frozen custard there, and kind of got their custard fixed throughout the winter months. Now, what percentage of those people do you think went back to that other store, store A, to get their frozen custard in the summer months? I would probably say not a lot. In fact, it wasn't enough to keep the business going. It's not there anymore. So customer loyalty is a hard element to put a dollar amount on, but there is a dollar amount there. So you may find that you may lose money in the winter time in order to stay open, but to keep your customers coming so they stay loyal to you in the summertime. So it's not just a financial spreadsheet to kind of figure out whether you're going to stay open, because there's much, much more involved, and your customers' loyalty and your customers' regularity in coming to your business may also be on the line. So give that some consideration. I know it's a hard choice to make, but a lot of times you need to figure out those two particular elements of the equation, not just the numbers, but customer loyalty and getting new customers coming through in those summer months. Hope that makes some sense to you. Again, we'll have some information down here in the show notes. If you have a question about this or any other topic about the ice cream or frozen industry that you'd like us to cover in the podcast, please drop us a line, steve@scoopschool.com. Subscribe, and we'll talk to you in the next video.